And welcome to Delta Conveyance Deep Dive, a series of online conversations about the proposed Delta Conveyance project. In these conversations, we hear from the experts about the complex conditions and issues surrounding the modernization of water infrastructure in the Delta. And we hope to dispel some myths and misunderstandings along the way. This episode is the second of a two-part discussion about state water project water allocations. Simply put, who receives water from the State Water Project and who gets to decide how much? In part one, we spoke with State Water Project Chief of Water Operations, Molly White, about the operations and regulations that govern the movement of water through the State Water Project. Today, we're going to take a look at how DWR works with the state's 29 public water agencies to supply water to more than 27 million Californians and 750,000 acres of farmland. And my guest today to help us do that is BG Heiland, Chief of the Water Management Group within the State Water Project Analysis Office. Hi, BG. Welcome to Deep Dive.
Happy to be here.
So first, can you tell us a little bit about your work here at DWR?
Sure. I've worked here for the Department of Water Resources a little over 20 years. I've been able to work in a variety of capacities, starting out in planning, working in surface storage, to river forecasting and flood operations, spent some time in executive as an advisor, and working on the Bay Delta Conservation Plan and water fix projects. But for the last 3.5 years, I've worked in the State Water Project Analysis Office, working on the Project Water Management Group. And we're involved with administering the water supply contracts, tracking the deliveries and working with some of the turnouts for our contractors, and then doing water rights and non-project water transfers.
Okay, so the whole topic of water allocations is pretty complicated, to say the least. So let's start with some of the basics. How are state water project water supplies allocated each year?
Great question. So we have what's called a contracted Table A amount. And essentially, our contractors sign up via a contract for to receive a certain allocation every year, up to their maximum amount that they contract for. And operations will move the water through the system to our contractors, all based upon how much rain we get each year within the Feather River watershed. There are some slight differences in allocations between those that are north of the Delta versus south of the Delta, because it takes a little bit of water to get through the Delta. But some of those details get pretty complicated pretty fast. And once our contractors receive that water, they have a variety of options looking at transfers or exchanges, and or looking at augmenting their supplies with non-project water, such as water from the Yuba watershed.
Great, thank you. I can see how it gets really complicated very quickly. But before we get into how those allocations might be affected by the Delta Conveyance Project, I'd like to back up just a little bit. And this is really basic, but could you describe for us what exactly a public water agency is and how they operate?
Of course, Pat. Of all the public water agencies in the state, 29 of those agencies contract for water from the State Water Project. I'll refer to them as contractors. And for those agencies, the State Water Project may only be one of their sources of water. There is a large range in size and location for those contractors. And it varies from agricultural districts to large urban suppliers. Location-wise, it can go as far north as Plumas County and go all the way down to Southern California for a metropolitan water district. For allocation amounts, it can be as small as several thousand acre feet, an acre foot being a football-sized field, 1 foot deep of water, to our largest contractor at 1.9 million acre feet. Of the contractors, looking at them overall, about 25% of our water is for agricultural, and then 75% is for municipal and industrial. And each year, those contractors are given an initial allocation that operations will regularly update throughout the winter. The contractors inform my team of their desires, given those allocations of when they want their water, so that we can start looking at the timing of deliveries. And after we get their, the contractors get their initial allocations, they have additional options available to them. The contractors can work amongst themselves to do with transfers or in exchanges. For some contractors that may not need all their water in a given year, to those that may need a little extra. And the contracts also allow the contractors to potentially store some of their water in San Luis Reservoir from one year to the next. And these tools have evolved and changed over time as we've had various amendments to those contracts.
All right. Now to the question of how the allocations to the water agencies would be affected by the Delta Conveyance Project. If the tunnel is built, how would state water project contracts change to accommodate it?
All right, good question. So Pat, with that, I just want to clarify that while the deliveries may change for the participating contractors, it will not increase the maximum contracted amount for those water contractors. We just went through a public negotiation process to get to an agreement in principle on Delta Conveyance. And the agreement in principle outlines what changes will be made to those water supply contracts. Having the Delta Conveyance facility will give the department additional flexibility to move water for those contractors that choose to participate. This facility will help address the potential impacts of sea level rise and climate change to help prepare us for the future. And for those contractors that choose to participate, they will receive a most likely a higher allocation than those contractors that choose not to participate. But the decision to participate is solely at the discretion of our contractors.
That's great. Thanks so much, BG. I think you really helped us get a handle on how the water allocation system works and how the Delta Conveyance Project would affect it in the future. Thanks for taking the time to explain it to us.
You're welcome. It's my pleasure, Pat.
And thank you for joining us. And I hope you tune in next time for another deep dive into the Delta Conveyance Project.